If you could please make your way to your seats, ladies and gentlemen. There is going to be an amazing dance party post the event where we can talk and shake a leg and cut up a rug and whatever other terminologies there might be. Thank you so much. Just give a couple of the ladies in the high heels a few more seconds to get to their seats. Thank you so much. Please again welcome Urban League of Eastern Massachusetts Board Chair Quincy Miller.
Okay, good evening everyone again. So tonight I would like to take an opportunity to provide a special recognition award to really someone who is a giant, someone who needs really no introduction. He is our friend, a champion of the people, a dedicated public servant, and our longest serving mayor. I would like to ask everybody in the room, please to stand with me now and recognize for this special recognition award, the Honorable Thomas M. Menino.
I know you can do better than that. When this city was wounded, here's somebody who stood up and made us Boston strong. Let's give it up for Thomas Menino.
Well, thank you, Quincy. Thank you, Donnell, for that introduction. And your new board chair, he has a lot to learn. You just think you're chairman, it means it's easy, you know, got a title, but being chairman, you have to direct the organization, making sure it happens. And let me tell you why I'm here tonight. Over my 20 years as mayor, I've worked with the Urban League on many different occasions, especially when it came to helping people and bridging the gap in the community of Boston. I've always done the work that's necessary, and that's to give people opportunities for a brighter future. You know, it's so important to have the Urban League here. I see Michael Curry, my other friend over there. These two organizations, oldest organizations, but you know, they haven't lost their mission. The mission is about people. Government has lost its mission. Government doesn't know what it's doing today. It's important that you have organizations like the NAACP, Urban League of Eastern Mass. All these organizations are helping people make a better way in their lives. So I just want to say, you know, you have to be there for Urban League, because those folks who come to those training programs would have no other place to go except for the Urban League. I want to thank also the recipients who are honored this evening for their special work. I know all of them, and they've all done a great job for our city. My two friends, my son-in-law, I can't say anything good about him. Nobody can. I know Jeff. You said good things about him. How the hell did you say good things about him? I have to say good things because I don't want my daughter to come home. That's why. And three kids. And the folks from Haley House. I mean, you haven't been to Haley House yet. You got to go. It's a great place for breakfast or lunch. It's a fabulous place. And you know, there's a perfect example of a nonprofit in Roxbury who's given people a second chance. Those folks who work behind that counter, who do those cooking, they came out of another different place, and they're being trained for a job for the future. So these two organizations we have today, Urban League, NAACP, Let's thank them. Mayors do the, I did my job for 20 years just because of these folks. You know, Darnell would haunt me for many different things. We always didn't agree. But you know something, we always agreed on the purpose. The purpose was about people. And let's continue to be about people and get some of our elected officials out there to understand it's not about me, it's about us. Now all of us work together to give people opportunities in our city and our country. Inequality is the biggest issue we have in our country today. Ask your elected officials what they're doing about inequality. That has to be dealt with. If we don't deal with it now, we're going to pay for it much later. So I just want to say thanks for having me here this evening. It's great to be with the folks in the River League, and thank you very much. Thank you.
Let's give the mayor another round of applause. Boston strong. We also have in our presence tonight the longest serving only African American woman in the House of Representatives, Gloria, State Representative Gloria Fox. Let's give her a round of applause. I got it right today. Michael Curry, you and I are doing some strident work together. I want to acknowledge you and Brenda, not only for you serving as the Boston branch, but now you're on the national board of the NAACP. And between you and me at the Urban League National Board, there has never happened in the city of Boston where we're serving together. I'm really proud of you. Thank you for being here tonight, my friend. I think the only thing that's standing between me and you and the entertainment is Monica introducing them, so I'm going to get out the way.
Almost. So we are going to have dessert, and we will be back with you. Just a reminder to please, again, go out and bid on the silent auction. I wanted to take this opportunity to again thank our corporate champions at the platinum level, Geico and State Street, at the gold level, Comcast, and at the silver level, CVS. We'll see you back here at 5 of 9. Thank you.